very high strike rate on Hirata. Undefeated 5-0. Radzuan is a spoiler, is an upsetter. Inside leg kick early from GF. Said the plan is to strike from a distance. If the takedown comes, she'll capitalize. Jihin also wants to show the world that she would have won the Atomweight Grand Prix. Clinching knee.
Good defense on the first takedown attempt from Jihin so far. She's got good movement, keeping her feet underneath her, and that's just going to build her confidence right there. That's important right there to get that first little bit of just confidence going on as she stops that first takedown. But did you see how fast Hirata got into that clinch?
Front kick there from Hirata, left hand hanging. Jihin, can she capitalize? Backs her against the wall here.
Look at Jihin trying to go for the takedown now, pressing Hirata up against the wall. She might choose to pull her to her left and trip out the leg there. Let's see if she can do that. But Hirata's doing a good job of keeping her back up against the wall so Jihin's not able to get a body lock. Now she's got it. Now you can see Hirata's got double underhooks, which is usually not a good spot to be in. But if she can take her left, right leg and step across, there could be a hip throw there. Jihin's really good at defending takedowns. Yeah, she's really good at defending takedowns, but that was important right there for Itsuki to spin her off. Oh, there it goes. Oh, good defense again from Jihin, and she's able to take the back almost.
Crowd appreciating the defense from Jihin Radzuan. Some knees to the sciatic area from Jihin. Now to the side of the thigh. Nice chamber on those knees, too. Good trajectory. What's Hirata going to look for here, Dragon?
She's going to try to spin around.
Don't just hold work.
And maybe go chest to chest. Try to get Jihin in front of her. There she goes. That, she's able to do it. Jihin pummels under. You can see all these little trip attempts from Itsuki are judo attempts. Judo throws she's looking for to put Jihin on the back. But Jihin's doing a great job of shutting down all these attacks. She said she spent a lot of time working with different judokas trying to shut down people's trip attempts.
Nice threaded knee to the top of the left ribs there from Hirata, and Jihin puts her against the fence once more.
Don't just hold, work.
Just past the halfway point of this opening round, set for 3 15-minute overall contest. Impressed by Jihin's start here, Dragon?
So far, so good, Michael. She's doing a really good job of shutting down all the takedown attempts and also landing things like that. Little short elbow on the exit and then back out in the middle of space, ready to put on a little bit of just volume right now. She needs to turn things up a little bit when she gets this opportunity. Start touching, start scoring points. Utilize the leg kicks. She's got really good leg kicks, and I'd like to see her use them. There it is again.
Hirata looking for that judo-style takedown, still couldn't affect it, though. Spent a lot of time against the wall, have these two ladies. What a shot there off the right from Jihin Radzuan, the Malaysian.
Jihin's got to be careful in these situations by putting too much weight forward. You don't want to start, you know, getting off balance, because that's when you get these momentum throws from Itsuki.
Radzuan's fought a lot of experienced opponents. She's fought two former world title challengers in Jenny Wang and most recently Mei Yamaguchi.
Let's go, action, action.
Beat both of them, of course.
Yeah, Michael, and that experience that she's got is really what she wants to lean on in this matchup. She wants to utilize just being in those high pressure situations and being against really tough opponents.
Stop, off the gate, step back, step back.
So referee Justin Brown recommences them from center circle. Wants more activity here. Jab from Radzuan. Looks for the outside leg and overhand right to a clinch attempt there, but Radzuan defends.
Yep. Oh, let's see, beautiful balance by the Shadow Cat. Always landing on her feet.
Oh, she's a cat.
She's got 11 cats at home that are cheering her on right now.
Hey, almost broke your record.
I only got one. Good pressure coming from Jihin right now. She's got Itsuki up against the wall. Itsuki needs to have a plan B. You know, if the judo isn't working, if the takedowns aren't working, she's got to change things up.
Hey, we'd like to welcome in now to our commentary, Rich Franklin. And Rich, great to have you with us here at 1X. Your thoughts on that opening round, Rich?
Hey, Michael, it's great to be here. I really like this opening round. Jihin's doing a great job of defending this throat, and I think that where she really needs to be careful here is that Itsuki's used to being in these situations where she may not succeed in the first attempt, the second attempt, or third attempt. And Mitch made a good point that she has to be careful, Jihin does, of getting herself overextended with her balance, because if Itsuki's patient, she'll end up landing that takedown at some point.
Great to have the Hall of Famer, the ace Rich Franklin, joining us for his expertise between rounds here as both corners deliver the instructions to their charges. We're ready to rock and roll. Second round set for three. Circle door closes. Does Hirata need to change it up? Is the judo not working for Itsuki Hirata? Saw Radzuan bound out of her corner. Maybe a confidence building round for Jihin. Backing up Hirata now.
Gotcha.
Looking for a takedown again, it's Hirata. Pressed up against the wall. What's Jihin looking to do here, Dragon?
Right now she's trying to control the head, control the posture of Itsuki. This is really important for Jihin to circle off of the wall.
Let's go.
There you go, nice little punch right there.
Nice little sidestep there from Jihin Radzuan, trying to close off any movement from Hirata.
It looks like Jihin's confidence is starting to grow because she's starting to push forward, and she's also starting to attempt takedowns, right? Because she's starting to catch kicks, push forward, and rush into these situations. Good sprawl.
Oh, nice defense again from Jihin Radzuan. Now Hirata presses her against the fence. Rich Franklin, do you agree here, Rich, that really we're seeing the confidence grow on Jihin Radzuan? Knees there from Jihin to the inside thigh, then the outside thigh, it's Hirata. Just staying busy inside this clinch position is Jihin Radzuan. And Rich, as I said, this has got to be a confidence-building round for Jihin Radzuan. Now, though, she gets taken down, and this is Hirata land. This is Hirataville! Jihin's going to find a way out of this predicament. This is where Hirata wants to be. Here comes the ground and pound, the elbows now. Kaminsky and Hirata. Jihin could be in trouble. Hirata wanted to go to town on it. Crowd loving it.
Good job by Jihin to work her way back up to her feet. She's got two on one now, peels the arm off. Itsuki finally landed that throw that was beautiful. And then Jihin was able to scramble back up to her feet and press Itsuki up against the wall.
Nice little spell there from Itsuki Hirata. And maybe the confidence has shifted, Dragon.
It is definitely going to be a boost to Itsuki's confidence to have that throw land.
Gotcha.
But
that.
You could see that she scrambled right back up to her feet. And again, that's only going to boost the ability of Jihin in her takedown defense, but also her ability to scramble and work her way back up to her feet. Oh, that was nice by Jihin. Oh, that was nice by Itsuki, but it gives up the back.
What a scrap we're seeing here in this Atomweight contest. Both women who believe they would have won the Atomweight World Grand Prix, who believe they would have been in tonight's pay-per-view main event at 1X against Angela Lee.
Itsuki's got a good hold on the left arm of Jihin, and she doesn't want to let it go. She's trying to turn in and go chest to chest, and she does just that. Good job. Let's see if Jihin can scramble back up to her feet.
Don't put your fingers in her glove. Don't put your fingers in her glove.
Maybe on the rise up from Itsuki Hirata. Against the fence once more, as we have been for so much of this contest. Rich Franklin, your thoughts here in the second round.
Man, Chevelle, Jihin's done a really good job of breaking her opponent down in camp here. She's really studied the way that Itsuki sets up her throws and whatnot. Even when she's been on the ground two times, she almost had Itsuki's back in that last throw, but she's been able to get back to her feet. I think we're at a point in this match where we're almost 10 minutes in, and Itsuki really needs to start thinking about a different kind of game plan, whether she starts unloading the hands or something like that, because she's just not being successful with these throws.
Beautiful job by Jihin to just hit her knee, pop right back up. She's got bad positioning right here. You can see the grip of Itsuki is really tight, and she's got good control, but Jihin just keeps popping right back up to her feet. Let's see if Jihin can swing that left arm over her head and go chest to chest. She might be able to slide back under. Itsuki is relentless with this takedown, but Rich is right. We gotta see a plan B from Itsuki.
No, just hold action. Let's go.
There is a tremendous amount of instruction coming from the corner of Itsuki Hirata. Wrenching takedown there from the Japanese athlete. What can she do from top position? Radzuan told us yesterday Hirata's got a very strong top game.
Look at Jihin going for the Ashigurami, going into a heel hook possibly. Let's see if Itsuki can defend. She reaches down. She does the right thing by trying to grab her leg and keep it protected. Let's see if this is the battle right here. See if she can extend the leg.
Final seconds of this round. And we are going in to the third round of action. Jihin Radzuan hoping for a submission in the dying stage in that round. What a performance from the Shadow Cat Dragon.
Ooh, that was interesting right there. But Itsuki was able to get another takedown. That was nicely done. But then Jihin immediately started scrambling. Jihin's got very good submission skills. There's a beautiful toss right there, put Jihin on her back. But then Jihin immediately started circling around and trying to take the back. Here's another one. Look at Itsuki, relentless with these takedown attempts, but this one worked well. But Jihin again scrambles back into a dominant position. Rich, what do you got for us, buddy?
Listen, after 10 minutes in this match, I have Jihin ahead on the scorecards. She's been doing a great job of defending these takedowns, and even when she hits the ground, she's able to pop back up. She's been able to land those shots that you talked about, Mitch, on the exits of all the clinches. So after 10 minutes, Itsuki, she needs to find a different game plan if she wants to be able to win this match or be successful with one of these throws eventually.
Lines from the Hall of Famer, the ace, Rich Franklin. Third and final round. Jab two there from Jihin Radzuan. High kick from Hirata.
That was nice.
Turns the right hand, backs up against the wall. It seems to be all for Itsuki Hirata to do. And the confidence is flowing through the veins of the young Shadow Cat from Malaysia.
But you can see the control that Itsuki has. Once this thing hits the ground, she knows exactly what she's looking for. But she doesn't really have another transition, right? She hits the throw, she goes into the head and arm, but then there's not a plan B. There's nowhere else for her to go. And that's where Jihin's able to scramble out of things. Good combination there into the double leg. Let's see if she can complete it. Puts Itsuki Hirata down.
Hirata looks at a bit of a loss. I think that Jihin's taken the steam out of her, taken the confidence, the cockiness out of her. And time now becomes an enemy of Itsuki Hirata.
Yeah, Jihin's famous for saying you have two opponents in there. One is your the fighter, and the other is the time, and she might run out of time here. Itsuki needs to do something big right now, because right now Jihin is looking really sharp. Good redirect right there for Itsuki as Itsuki is trying to press her up against. Nice little short elbow landed by Hirata.
And a good popping right hand. Benjian straight back onto her. Can she affect another takedown? Switches to a single here.
Look, Jihin's got no fear in going for these takedowns. Driving in, circles past the legs. Let's see if she can turn her down, put her back on her backside. But it looks like Itsuki's working her way back up. Good job by Jihin to lace those legs. Triangle the legs. Nicely done. Let's see if she can turn her off the wall. She's going to try to pull the hips away from the wall so that Itsuki's not able to use the wall to walk back up. Itsuki's got to free one of her legs if she wants to be successful here and get back up to her feet.
Let's go. Work the finish. Work the finish. Let's go.
That Itsuki Hirata thought she would have. She came in undefeated 5-0. And Radzuan has closed her down. Nice little threaded left hand over the top there from the Shadow Cat. 2 minutes 23 remaining in the contest. What can Hirata do to swing the pendulum dragon?
You can see she's trying to utilize her legs to reap inside to create that fulcrum, basically to put it on her back. But beautiful job by Jihin as she's able to turn the corner and put Hirata down.
This is a performance and a half from Jihin Radzuan, now inside the guard of Hirata. Under 2 minutes remaining.
Jihin has done her homework to stop these judo takedown attempts. She's in the guard. Let's see what Hirata is like off of her back. We rarely see Hirata in the guard position. Let's see if Itsuki can get some kind of offense going here. Jihin's burying her shoulder into the chest there, or the stomach rather, of Itsuki. You can see Itsuki's trying to throw up the legs, possibly looking for some kind of omoplata or go-go plata even.
Don't just hold, but work to finish. Work to finish, let's go.
She's trying to pull her into what's called rubber guard, but Jihin's just not giving her that opportunity by smothering her down there.
Radzuan trying to become the first person to defeat Hirata. Hirata hunting after that arm.
Oh, Jihin, but Jihin used it to pass.
Takes it back. Put your back against the fence. How about this from Jihin Radzuan? This crowd loving every moment of this performance from the Malaysian Shadow Cat. This win, if she wins it tonight, it will be three straight wins, and it should break her into the top five in the heated atomweight division. But Hirata's not done yet. There's still 35 seconds remaining. 25 seconds on the clock now. Has Hirata got something special? Jihin off her back. Nice kick to the lead knee, then to the shin there from the Shadow Cat, defending. Is there a desperation technique left here for Itsuki Hirata? Slings the legs.
The back up.
Justin
go,
Brown
up,
allows Jihin up. A final salvo maybe from Itsuki Hirata. Something. Anything. Jihin backs out of the way, and we are going to the judges. Jihin does a celebratory dance. Usually it's Hirata dancing and posing for the cameras. This time it's Radzuan who is dancing and posing. Well, well, well. Most people thought it would be Hirata's night. We will see what the judges say. The aggression, the defense, the offense from Jihin Radzuan. Look at this. Straight in on Hirata. Hirata broke off beautifully to use an elbow there to the cheekbone. But it didn't seem to faze Jihin. Came straight back on it. Butterfly hook there. Looked trying to wrench the arm. Looked for a late submission attempt, and Jihin just pops out. Escapes, takes the back. Beautiful work from the Shadow Cat. Okay, let's go to Tom Lau for our decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of Radzuan. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of Hirata. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision, Jihin!